obtain the equivalent capacitance in the network. Also calculate charge and voltage across each capacitor. Given C1 is equal to C4 equals 100 picofarad, C2 equals C3 equals 200 picofarad. So the given circuit is like this. I can rewrite this as, I'll write the C4 here, and then I'll write C2 and C3. This is C2, this is C3, this is C4, and here is C1. So the given circuit can be modified like this. So here it is connected to 300 volt supply. This is your C1. So C1 and C4 are given 100 picofarad, C2, C3 are 200 picofarad. Now, C2 and C3 are in series. So both are 200 picofarad. So effective of these two will be equal to 100 picofarad. 200, 200 are in series, effective will be 100. Now, C1 and C2 in series with C3, this combination, these two are in parallel. So effective capacitance will be Cp is equal to 100 and 100 are in parallel. So this will be, this entire thing will be equal to 100. This is equal to 100. So it will be 200 picofarad. So this entire combination put together will be 200 picofarad. Now this 200 picofarad is in series with this 100 picofarad. So Cp is in series with C4. Therefore, what do you get? Effective capacitance, or we'll call it as equivalent capacitance, that will be equal to 100 into 200 divided by 100 plus 200, that is equal to 200 by 3 picofarad. So this is effective capacitance of the combination. So next we need to find charge and voltage across each capacitor. So total charge Q is equal to C into V. Total capacitance is 200 by 3 into 10 power minus 12 picofarad it is. Potential is 300. So that turns out to be 20 nanocoulomb. This is total charge. Now, charge on C1 should be equal to Q1, that is C1 V1. Charge on C1 is Q1 is equal to C1 into V1. So C1 is 100 picofarad. So V1 is voltage across the parallel combination. So voltage across parallel combination will be 100 volt. So that will be equal to 10 nanocoulomb. Then charge on C2 should be equal to charge on C3. So these two should be equal. That is Q2 is equal to Q3. That should be equal to 10 nanocoulomb. So it will become 10 nanocoulomb each. Then charge on C4 should be Q4. That should be equal to C4, V4. C4 is 100 picofarad. Voltage across C4 is 200. 300 get divided into 100 and 200. So it will become 20 nano coulomb. So this is charge on each capacitor. So voltages are V1 is equal to 100 volt. V2 is equal to V3. Both are in series, both are equal. So it will be 50 volt each. 50 plus 50 will make it 100. V4 will be equal to 200 volt. So this is what they had asked for.